keep them going. Thick wheels rolling, moving on. The white line is the lifeline to a nation. And men like Will and Sonny make it move. A good hot cup of coffee is waiting up ahead. And the rhythm of the highway hums along. Jamming gears has got to be a fever. Cause men become addicted to the grind. It takes a special breed to be a truck driving man. And a steady hand to pull that load behind. Big wheels rolling, gotta keep them going. Big wheels rolling, moving on.
Yeah, we
Sonny, did. Will, Merry Christmas. Happy
oh,
New
yeah,
Year.
Thank you, Tony. Same to you.
Tony, you know I forgot all about Christmas. You didn't get me anything?
Thanks a lot.
What do you get for a man who has nothing?
Well, I got a list.
You want something to eat?
I don't know. What time is it?
French fries and some coffee just as soon as you can find it.
Mm. Okay. Any rye bread?
I have tuna fish on rye toast and tea with lemon. With me, honey?
Forget it.
You look at that. No. That.
Makes you wish it was Columbus Day, doesn't it?
Where are we going to spend our Christmas?
I'll tell you one thing, it ain't going to be here.
Oh, it doesn't matter. Vegas, Boise, Boston, New Orleans. So still get your basic holiday special.
Boy, when I think of the Christmas dinners I've had. My Aunt Gert sets a table you just can't believe. Roast turkey with a chestnut dressing. And scalloped oysters. I've never tasted them any place
else.
She has to order them special from the East.
Who delivers them, the three wise men?
Four kind of pies. Apple, rhubarb, mince, and sweet potato with a marshmallow topping.
Marshmallow topping? Well, now I know where you get your slim white bread figure.
Uncle Mike makes the plum pudding. He just sloshes on the brandy. Four bites and you got a buzz off. Forget it.
Dream on. I know what our holiday feast is gonna be.
No way. Not this year.
Do eat Chinese?
Nope, we're going home. Uncle Mike and Gertz. By damn, we are.
You're gonna have a real great homecoming, huh?
Yep. We're gonna have a fine time.
Sure you want me to come along?
Yeah, man, whenever you want to. I want to visit my son's grave or check in with my daughter-in-law. Then I thought I'd drop in on a few of the old hangouts. Maybe check on a couple girls I used to know.
What about your ex? You gonna check her out?
Dinah, are you kidding? No way. I have enough communication with her when I'm late with the alimony. The telegrams, the letters, the lawyers. Well, you know, it wasn't all her fault, really. I was on the road a lot. That didn't help.
But it just seemed every time I was home, we were always fighting. Hey, you know what else I'm going to do? I'm going to grab a couple of dance lessons. My card's still good.
Oh, boy. Don't you ever give up.
I can't. They keep inventing new dances. Hey. It's the county line. We're almost there.
Boy, anybody who lives around here has got to be a drinker.
Well, we always used to say, sand in your face, sand in your hair. You never starve in Phoenix, because the sandwich is there. About a little high school humor.
Yeah.
Hey, what's going on over there? Let's stop and take a look.
Like a race.
Bunch of truckers.
It's a good way to screw up a tractor. They're moving pretty good.
Howdy.
Hi.
Some of the guys just working out.
Working out? It's like a race to me.
Yeah, a race not till Christmas Day. Nice looking rig you've got there.
Oh, thanks.
You be Pruitt?
Yeah, Sonny Pruitt. You?
Malone, Jerry Malone.
Will Chandler.
Will?
Jerry.
Yeah.
Real race, huh?
Each man puts up $500 and winner takes all. Got room for one more, you'd make six. Chance to pick up $2,500.
Chance to pick up a lot of dirt.
No guts, eh?
He say no guts?
Yeah, that's what he said.
Is that what he said? Now, just a minute. This rig of ours can match anybody you got out here.
Put your money where your mouth is. A good-looking rig. Needs a good driver, too. Those fellas, they're drivers.
Oh. And so what are we, a couple of taxi drivers? Hey. A couple... Hey. Can go home again.
Hey, on the way I can show you where I was born.
I know it's Christmas, but if you take me to a manger.
It's just down the street a little bit. Okay, slow down. That's it.
That?
521 Portland Street. That's where I was born.
Hey, Sonny, that's sweet. Black.
What black?
Black, you know, the plaque the city fathers put up saying Sonny Pruitt was born here.
Don't worry. They will.
Love barging in on people.
They're not people. It's my Uncle Mike, Aunt Gert. They asked me home for Christmas.
So long, right?
Come on. Oh, hey, one thing about Uncle Mike, he is a little hard of hearing.
What?
No, he's hard of hearing. So when you talk to him, just speak up a little.
Okay. Knock louder.
I'll check the neighbors. Maybe they know where they are.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, yeah, Merry Christmas. I'm Sonny Pruitt, Mike Pruitt's nephew.
Oh, they're going to be so disappointed. Oh?
Mm-hmm.
Because they've gone away.
To Las Vegas.
Where we just came from.
Well, now, isn't that a coincidence?
Well, thanks a lot. Merry Christmas. Oh,
Merry Christmas.
Wait till you taste my Aunt Gert's cooking.
Come on, knock it off.
First there's the bird, naturally.
Hey, come on.
Then there's the scalloped oysters, the 23 different kinds of pie, and the plum pudding drenched in brandy.
Look, I promised to get you a Christmas dinner. I'm going to get you a Christmas dinner.
Where?
I'll call Julie, my daughter-in-law.
Oh.
She's an old-fashioned kind of girl. I'll bet you she can cook up a storm.
Well, that's a good idea. She's probably spending Christmas in Moscow.
Hey.
Drenched in brandy.
What do you know? Library Park.
Oh
boy, what the memories that brings back.
It was here that the sweet mystery of love with all its agony and ecstasy was first revealed to you.
How did you know?
According to Dr. Kinsey, it happens to 9 out of every 10 Americans in a place like this. Besides, you had that gleam in your eye. I suppose you want to talk about it.
Angela Morley. I called her Angel.
You were very clever even then.
Oh, she was gorgeous. Tall and slim and built. And she just happened to be nuts about me.
So, what happened to Angela?
Oh, well, Angel was ambitious. Wanted to be a model. So, right after graduation, she went to New York. She's probably married to some financier by now. Oh, she was just something special.
Sonny, can we go now and find a phone booth and call your daughter-in-law?
Oh, yeah, I just kind of hate to leave. Right.
Attaboy.
Right, gotcha. Yeah, I'll be there. Right,
fine. Oh, hey, Julie, that's fine. Sure, I'll see you then. Right, bye, babe.
Sonny Fruin.
Yeah.
Jack Wentworth?
Hey!
You old son of a gun.
You old son of a
gun. How the hell are you?
Oh, great. How the hell are you?
Oh, I can't believe this. I haven't seen you since graduation.
Listen, that was just practically yesterday, right?
Hey, put on a couple of pounds, I see.
Yeah, you lost a few hairs, I see.
Hey, Sonny, you remember?
Do I? Oh, man, do I remember.
We had some good times.
You know what? They were the best. The very best. Hey, come here. I want you to meet my partner, Will Channer. He's an old high school buddy, Jack Wentworth. Can you believe that?
You do.
Nice to meet you, Will.
Nice to meet you.
Hey, you guys own this thing?
Well, me and the bank.
It's a beauty. Listen, I'm afraid I have a terribly important appointment. But why don't you walk with me a little bit?
Paul, we got some time.
Sonny,
good. Wait till I tell the missus. She won't believe it.
You know something? I don't hardly believe it. We got to get together and really shoot the breeze, okay?
Right. Hey, maybe I could have a belt or two with you.
Okay.
No, I better not. How about tonight?
Well, I don't know about tonight. Can I give you a call?
I'm in the book. Wait a minute. I have an even better idea. You remember the gardens?
Do I remember the gardens? Don't tell me it's still there. Hey, what about Chan, that old grouchy bartender? He's still there?
No. He died a couple of years ago. Terrible emphysema.
In Arizona?
Yeah. Well, anyway, my wife and I are there practically every night, so why don't you just stop in and see us tonight, tomorrow, whenever, huh?
That's okay with me. Hey, old buddy.
Old buddy. Wait till I tell the missus. So long, pal.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you, Will.
Yeah, so long.
See you, Jack. Just a terrific guy.
What about your daughter-in-law?
Oh, I'm going to meet her later at the cemetery. Can you believe
Christmas dinner.
Oh. Julie's having Christmas dinner with Dinah.
Okay.
I don't want to get
involved. Forget it.
Look,
forget
I promise you, it'll work out.
Hang around here. It makes me nervous.
Why?
They put one like this up in Boston. All the windows blew out.
Oh. Hey, Will, you got to... Just to, you know, give her something. We got a little time to kill. Why don't we go over to...
my old dancing school, I'll spring for a lesson. I think you could use one.
I'd rather sit out and let you take the lesson. I like to watch.
Yeah. All right, just don't laugh.
And that's it? Just like that? Oh, I'll bet you're sorry. Well, listen to me. If you think you... Okay, I'll let you finish. Oh, you just said all that. Suddenly, out of nowhere, you're giving me the brush. Well, let me tell you something.
No, it can't be.
If you think you're going to get away with just trampling on my feelings... Sonny?
Dinah?
Oh, is that so? Well, I've got news for you.
Let's get out of here.
Oh, no.
Come on, Will.
I'm not going to miss this.
Sonny, come back here. Sonny! Oh!
What? Dinah?
Oh,
Sonny. Oh, nice. Sonny, she's gorgeous.
Yes, she is.
And very young. Cradle robber, you.
I can't believe it.
Well, it's me, all right. Hey, I didn't mean to overhear part of your phone conversation. You got a problem?
Oh, no, it isn't me that's got the problem. What a surprise.
Yeah, for me, too. Oh, this is my partner, Will Chandler.
Hi. Oh, hi. Well, how long has it been? And why didn't you let me know you were going to show up? What a mess.
You're kidding. You look great.
So do you. Let me look at you. Yes, you're definitely older.
Oh, come on.
I'm only kidding you, because you're just as gorgeous as ever.
No improvement, whatever.
So when did you get in Phoenix?
Oh, just a little while ago, about an hour.
And you came right here to see
me? No, I came for a dancing lesson. I didn't even know that you worked here.
Gallant, as ever.
So, how long are you going to stay, and where are you staying?
Well, we were going to stay with Uncle Mike and Aunt Gertz, but they've gone to Vegas.
You're going to stay with me.
No.
I have plenty of room.
Now, Dinah, I don't think that's a good idea.
Oh, why not?
Well...
Are you afraid I'm going to seduce you? Though that wouldn't be too hard to do. Sonny, you're still so sexy looking.
Oh, honey.
You see why I married this wonderful lug? So it's settled,
no,
huh?
No, now, wait a minute. I got a lot of things I want to do. I don't want to have to be any place at any special time. I don't want to have to be nice to... All those friends of yours are going to come dropping in.
All of my friends,
yeah.
Huh? Oh, yes, I see that you forgot about your poker parties. It took me 2 weeks to clear out the cigar smoke.
Now, how many poker parties could I have had? I was on the road most of the
time.
Boy,
you sure were. And you just hated to come home, didn't you?
Home? Is that what you call it with all those strays you drag in with their sob stories? You know, I'm not kidding. If a bum came for a handout, you know what she'd say to him? Well, why don't you stay for dinner, stay the night, stay a week, and just make yourself at home?
How long has he been your partner, huh? Not very long, I'll guarantee you that. Because you just show me somebody who can put up with his habits, and I'll show you...
Put up with my habits? Listen, the whole problem we've had...
Excuse me, both of you. I'm sure you got a lot of things to talk over, you know, all the good old times, so I'll just be taking off.
Hey, wait a minute. Take off for what?
Well, I've never seen Phoenix, so I'll just get a room at the truck stop.
No,
have a look
come
around.
On. How about our big Christmas dinner?
Oh, that's
you're
okay.
Having Christmas with me?
No.
Yes. I've made a feast, and Julie's coming. Wait, I'll give you the address. Christmas dinner is at 2:00, and please don't eat any breakfast Christmas morning, huh? Leave lots of room, huh?
Oh, I'll do that. Don't worry.
Okay.
I'm having Christmas dinner with you, you marvelous lug.
Sonny, I'm sorry we argued.
She didn't take us long to get right back where we left off.
I know it. Marvelous.
No.
Come on, I'm going to take you home. Then I have something awful I have to do.
Dinah! Howdy, honey!
Sonny, this is Slim Dexter. Slim, I want you to meet Sonny Pruitt.
Sonny Pruitt?
Yeah.
Well, he's got the same last... Sonny Pruitt? Hey, Sonny, this is really a pleasure. Yeah, Donna told me all about you. Now, here you are. Well, I just can't believe it. Well, welcome, Sonny. Gee, it's mighty nice to lay eyes on you.
Thanks. Hello.
You're going to be staying with us, ain't you? Huh? Well, I sure hope so. Listen, Dinah's laying out a spread for Christmas. Ought to be able to fill up a whole bunkhouse full of food.
I might be staying with you.
Slim is fixing up his car. Isn't it a beaut?
Oh, yeah, that's cute.
Oh, Sonny, you stay here and get settled, and I'll be back in a little...
Dinah, I promised Julie I'd meet at the cemetery. Could you drop me off?
Oh, I told you I had some... Well, okay, if you don't mind making a stop first.
That's fine.
Hey, Sonny, I'll get your room ready. Move in right next to me.
Great. Now, who is Slim?
Slim? Slim is just Slim?
Slim is just crazy about you.
Don't be silly.
I can tell, Dinah. I know it's none of my business.
That's true. There is nothing between Slim and me. Oh, maybe he has a crush on me.
He's living with you.
The house is so big.
I pay you a fortune in alimony. You got a job. What do you have to rent rooms for?
Oh, he doesn't pay.
Doesn't pay.
Well, no. I mean, he would if he could, but he doesn't have a job, so he doesn't have any money.
No job, no money. Just got a car that's worth a fortune. You're keeping him.
That's none of your business.
On my alimony?
Didn't figure on seeing you again.
Still got an opening?
Yeah, too rich for most truckers.
$500.
Right, chance to win $2,500.
You racing?
Sure, there's my baby.
It's nice. Guess you're not gonna try out.
Nah, I know what my baby can do.
They're okay.
Can you handle them?
I don't know if I can handle you.
You want me to try out?
Oh, I just like to check out my competition.
Can't blame you, but I got a rule. I only race in races.
Pretty sure of yourself.
I always win.
You're souped up.
Come out Christmas morning. You can see me. If you want to race me, it's going to cost you.
$500.
That's $250.
Well, I'll come up with the rest of it. Where do I take this?
You can leave it with me.
No offense, Mr. Malone, but who do I give the money to?
Ah, that little feller over there. Merry Christmas.
Yeah, that's my plan.
You get out to the cemetery very much?
I know it's awful, but I'd like to go out there.
Not awful. You just want to remember Vic the way he was when he was alive. How's Julie doing?
I don't see her as often as I like to. She keeps to herself.
She was sure crazy about Vic.
It's been 2 years.
She go out much?
I fixed her up a couple of times with very nice boys, and she just didn't seem interested.
What's the matter with you? Matchmaking for your own son's
widow? I love Julie. She's 23 years old, and I don't want to see her be a widow for the rest of her life, thank you. What about your friend Will? He's gorgeous in a scruffy kind of way.
Do me a favor, huh? Don't.
Don't worry, I won't. He's a trucker, like you. I'll be right back.
Hey,
like that. A phone call, not even face to face.
I thought it'd be easier.
Oh, easier for you, right?
Look, come on, we had a lot of good times.
Oh, yes, and I shouldn't spoil a memory of all those good times by complaining. Boy, you have a nerve. After 3 years, a phone call. That's what really bugs me.
Dinah, please.
Ask you a question. What happened after 3 years, all of a sudden you're calling it off?
I'm going to try to save my marriage.
Oh, that's nice. I thought it had something to do with me.
You want a drink?
Vincent, you really are a dummy. I mean, I knew it had to end sometime, but you never stop to think about how I would feel. I have my pride, you know.
I bought you this. I was going to have it delivered.
Thank you a lot.
Well, Dinah, don't be mad.
Mad? Oh, who, me? Why should I be mad? I don't mind being dumped, especially at Christmas.
Well, I don't blame you for being upset, but I mean, you've got to realize that I've got to straighten things out with my wife.
Why? You haven't seen her in a month.
I'm flying to Miami Christmas morning.
Oh, how sweet. Do give her my best.
Dinah, you're a great gal. I've never known anyone like you.
And I've never given you any trouble, have I?
Never.
Well, all that is going to change. Merry Christmas.
Dinah! Dinah!
And a happy new year!
Dinah! Dinah! Nothing stupid.
I don't know what you're talking about.
My wife doesn't know about you, and I don't want her to.
Oh, what does she think you've been doing for the past 3 years?
I'm not kidding.
Vincent, you're hurting me.
Hey. Take your hands off her.
Who the hell are you?
Just do it now.
It's okay. Shouldn't have done that. Now get him the hell out of here.
Sonny, let's go. Oh, thanks for the Christmas present, rat.
Do you mind telling me what that was all about?
You wouldn't be interested.
I would be very interested. Those gorillas had guns.
Sonny, it is none of your business. If you think that you can just barge in here after all the years you've been gone and butt into my affairs...
They were pointing those guns at me.
Well, it won't happen again. It's all over with.
Dinah!
I don't want to talk about it, Sonny. It's finished.
Still miss him?
Very much. Good to see you. I hear I'll be seeing you on Christmas Day.
That Dinah is a beaut.
She's really glad you're here.
I tell you, Julie, when I decided to come home for Christmas, the one thing I was not going to do was to see her. Well, not only did I see her, I'm staying with her.
She really hasn't changed very much, has she?
Changed? She's worse than ever. Half an hour after I met her, two guys with guns were pointing them at me.
What?
She said, well, you know, it's none of your business, so just forget it. So I forgot it. And then there's Slim living with her.
Yeah, Slim's nice. Hey, you're not worried about any kind of romance.
No, I'm not worried about anything.
Well, if you should happen to get worried, you can forget about him. Although I think that he's pretty crazy about her.
I don't blame him for that. I mean, he's living very well. It's not costing him a dime. I tell you, if I could find a woman like that, I'd marry her.
Do you ever think about getting back together with Dinah again?
Yep. And I take a cold shower and I stop thinking about it.
She's a wonderful lady.
Yeah, she's okay. A little freaky.
You're a terrific guy.
I was just a bad combination. Just never worked out.
You had Vic.
Yeah. He was the best part of the whole deal. nice shape.
Real rare vehicle.
What kind of work you do?
How do you mean work?
Work. Job.
Oh. Well, to tell you the truth, I don't really have a job. Used to help out at the ranch, my daddy's place. But he fired me.
Your daddy fired you?
Yeah. Never was much of a cowboy.
What do you think she'll do?
Do? You mean how fast? Beats me. Never opened her up. Fact is, I keep her right here in the driveway.
How you doing, guy?
Hey, come on, I want you to meet my partner.
Doing here? Well, a little red cap. I brought your bag down here.
Oh. Hey there, Julie. How are you?
Hi, Slim.
Julie, it's my partner, Will Chandler. Will, this is my daughter-in-law, Julie.
How do you do, Julie?
Hi.
I thought you were going to see the sights.
I saw them. How much can you see without a guide?
Absolutely right. Why don't you go with me? I'll not only show you Phoenix, I'll show you the Phoenix that made Sonny Pruitt what he is today.
Well, I figured urban renewal took care of that a long time ago.
Thanks. See you later. Bye. Nice to have met you.
Same here. You be here for Christmas dinner?
Yes.
Well, I'll see you then.
Bye.
Bye.
Hey, Slim, I'd like to borrow your car.
Huh?
I said I'd like to borrow your car, okay?
Borrow it? You mean driver?
Yeah, that's what I had in mind.
Anna, come on,
Dinah honey. Said that you'd let me borrow it any time.
She did?
She did. Give me the keys. Thanks. Hang that up for me, will you?
Sonny?
Yeah.
I'm still invited?
Oh, sure. I'm going to pay a visit to my old high school.
Oh. Well, I'd like that. I might be able to figure out something about your background, see what makes you tick.
I was a big man.
Sometimes it's pretty hard to understand this guy.
Hey, Sonny.
Yeah?
Easy, huh? She's a real sensitive critter.
Don't worry about a thing.
Hey, why didn't you tell me that, Julie was a looker?
You noticed, huh?
Hard not to.
Hey, hands off.
Well, I would never. She was turned right off. Guess I'm losing my touch.
That Dinah.
Yeah. She's gorgeous, isn't she?
Well, she must have been a baby when you got married.
Yeah, well, in those days, I was driving for a diaper company.
Did you ever think about going back to her?
I wish people would stop asking me that. You were there. You saw what happened. Haven't seen her for years. Within 2 minutes, we're in the middle of a big fight.
Yeah, well, they tell me that's the way it is.
Very funny.
Well, here's something else that's funny. How'd you like to loan me $250?
You're just full of jokes today, aren't you?
It's no joke.
Well, it better be.
Ebenezer Pruitt.
Lousy $250. That's all. I'll pay you back soon.
What do you need it for? You just got paid.
Well, I can't tell you that. I don't want to spoil the surprise.
You mean it? It's for a Christmas present?
See? You see that? You spoiled it.
Here it is. This is where I spent 4 of the happiest years of my life. Nothing's changed. Same old place. I remember every afternoon about this time we'd be heading out to the field for baseball practice.
Oh, now you're going to tell me the story about the big New Year's Day game with the rivals from across.
across town.
No, but you know something? I do happen to hold the record for the only unassisted triple play in this high school.
Come on, there's nobody here.
Wait a minute. It's Mademoiselle Stendhal.
Who is she, one of the trainers?
No, my old French teacher. Mademoiselle Stendhal? Mademoiselle?
Oui?
Sonny Pruitt, class of 42.
Ah, Monsieur Pruitt.
Oui.
Je suis enchantée de vous voir, Monsieur Pruitt. Comment allez-vous depuis 1942?
Bien, j'espère.
Oui.
Ça fait plaisir de voir des anciens amis.
Oui.
Vous êtes très gentil d'être venu me voir.
Oui.
Je dois corriger des manuscrits maintenant. Il faut que je m'en aille. Vous travaillez, n'est-ce pas?
Oui.
You still speak French beautifully. I'm very glad you must keep it up.
Soyez enchanté de faire votre connaissance, mademoiselle.
Vous aussi, vous êtes un linguiste?
Savoir sans dire. Au revoir.
Au revoir.
Joyeux Noël.
Merci.
Show off.
Hey, Pruitt, why don't you wait for me?
Not only get your money back, you'll make a profit on the deal.
How can I make a profit off a Christmas present?
Sonny, have I ever asked you for money before?
Hey, I think we're being followed.
Some of your old hot-rodding buddies back there, huh?
Wait till I get my hands on that diner.
Yeah, my next life is not in this.
No, this thing's got no power at all.
Don't blame the car. It's not allowed out of the house all the time.
No, you shouldn't have done that to Mr. Felton.
Who is Mr. Felton?
Mr. Felton shouldn't have put his hands on a woman.
Sonny, who is Mr. Felton?
We catch you there, Mr. Felton, again. You're really going to be in a jam.
You just tell Mr. Felton.
Sonny, who is Mr. Felton?
I'm in the kitchen.
Okay. Who is Felton?
Oh. Sonny, Will. What's
look,
happened?
I want to know, what's with this guy Felton? And don't tell me it's none of my business.
He is someone I used to know.
You know those two guys that tried to clobber me when we were up at his house? They were waiting for us here.
Oh, that's terrible. I'm so sorry.
Well, who is the guy?
Oh, I'll tell you later.
Why don't you tell me now while I'm still bleeding?
Oh, his eyes.
Look, I don't want to break up your reunion. I'll see you for Christmas dinner.
Dinah, who is the guy?
He's Vincent.
Sonny.
What?
You're going to make me a personal loan.
All right, Dinah.
Sonny.
Who is Vince?
Sonny, he doesn't make $250.
Dinah?
Here's some ice. Take it easy, easy.
Who is Vince?
He's someone I used to go with.
Used to? When did you stop?
Today.
Well, is that why he was giving you the muscle? Because you gave him the brush?
No, he gave me the brush.
Well, what was he so mad at you about?
Oh, I suppose he thought I was going to tell his wife.
You fooling around with a married man?
Have you seen the single ones?
How long have you gone with him?
3 years.
You can sure pick him. How'd you meet him?
The same way that I met you, Sonny. He came into dancing school for some lessons.
Dinah, do you have any idea what he does or who he is? I mean, I've seen some hoods, and those pals of his are hoods.
Are you suggesting that Vince is a hood?
No, I'm just suggesting that his pals are hoods. I mean, I think Vince is probably a school teacher, or he runs a pet shop, or he sells living Christmas trees.
Sonny, you are so dramatic.
I grew up here.
Oh, good. Come on.
What?
Sonny said you'd show me around.
Look, I've got a lot of stuff I have to do.
Just take a second, all right? Get in the tractor outside and we'll go, all right?
Okay, just a minute.
Your men to manhandle Sonny.
Donna, go sit down. I'll take care of
you. You'll do nothing.
Oh, listen, I don't care how many boys you got out
there. Now, you shut up and listen. You're in trouble. I want it back right now.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Dinah, this is no joke. Give it to me right now or I'll tear this place apart.
Vincent, I am totally mystified as to what you're referring
to. What's he talking about?
You don't know?
I don't know.
Boy, have you guys made a mistake? You don't know who I am, do you?
Well, I got an idea.
Well, then stop fooling with me. You're never going to get away with it anyway. Nobody's going to buy it from you. I got every outlet covered. Nobody's going to touch the thing. So why don't you guys just spare yourself a lot of grief and give it back right now?
Would somebody please fill me in?
Oh, I would be delighted to, but I am totally in the dark.
Dinah, you don't realize what you've done.
Vincent, Sonny thinks that you're some kind of a gangster. Are you some kind of a gangster?
Dinah,
the joke is over, Dinah.
Like everything else, huh?
The necklace is worth $20,000.
What necklace?
But you can't get a nickel for it. Take my word.
What necklace? Well, I'm sorry. I haven't the faintest idea where your necklace is.
Felton, there's no necklace here, believe me.
You said a minute ago you know something about me. So you know what? I'm going to kid you, eh? It's a big desert out there. It's going to take a long time for somebody to find you. Maybe nobody's ever going to find you. You just try to get rid of that thing and see what happens.
Look, I'm telling you
I am telling you I want that here by tomorrow night.
Dinah?
I don't have the necklace.
Well, he thinks you do. Why? Look, Will and I have already tangled with his boys. They don't kid around. He doesn't kid around.
Well, I don't want you and Will to be hurt.
Well, we're gonna get hurt.
Well, I don't have the necklace.
Then where is it? Did you take it?
Oh, I hate to give it back. Rat. I mean, to break it up just before Christmas. That's what really bugs me.
you.
Welcome aboard. Let me explain a couple of rules.
All right.
Race starts 12 noon, Christmas Day sharp. You don't show up, we don't wait. You don't show up, you forfeit your money.
Right, thank you, Mr. Malone. You're pointedly direct. See you at Christmas.
You're really going to race this thing?
Yep, I certainly am.
Does Sonny know about this? I mean, it doesn't seem like something that he would do.
It's a surprise. Please, don't tell him. That is an example of what happens when you race on an empty stomach.
What?
And to avoid repetition of such accidents, let's have dinner tonight.
Thanks, but...
Seafood. I like to go to the best seafood restaurant in Phoenix.
Seafood?
Yeah.
Phoenix?
Yeah.
We're kind of a long ways from the ocean.
Well, that doesn't bother me, although it's probably pretty rough on a fish. Come on.
It's another corny joke, Mr. Chen.
You know, I don't get it. I don't remember you ever stealing anything.
I didn't steal the necklace. I took it.
Oh, excuse me.
If I had stolen it, it wouldn't be where it was right now. Oh, here. Stop here. Just pull right in this parking lot.
Here?
Yes. You'll see. Go right over there.
I know where to park it.
Oh, Tucker, that's so smart. I only took it because I was mad at him. I mean, after 3 years, he calls me on the telephone to tell me that he's finished. Did you ever hear of such a thing? Sonny, you wouldn't do that.
In the supermarket?
Oh, no, it's here.
You gotta be kidding.
No, I put it in there. I don't want his old necklace. His wife's necklace.
You are a pip. But you always were. I can't see a thing in here. Listen, kind of keep a lookout for me, will you? You're liable to think I'm pulling a hijack.
That beige snakeskin bag you gave me for a Christmas present. You know, if you didn't think that you and Will would be hurt by him, well, I'd just as soon never give it back. Let some poor family get it.
It's not here. Nothing's here. It's empty.